Hey everyone, back in the shop today, working on Clyde some more. I finally got the headers done on the car. I ended up having to cut the flanges off, as you guys know, and flip them over because on an LT, they are not symmetrical. So you can either go the way they're designed, which is back and down, or like front and down, but you can't come up and forward. I originally wanted to turn it, go back along the frame rail, and I figured this is probably just gonna be the best way I can come up. I'm gonna bring it over, go through the fender, and then run it probably back around here to the side of the car, come behind the suspension, and maybe come out right here. I could either do like a little bullhorn or kind of like on the Buick, do side pipes or something like that for driving it. So if I'm ever ready and I want to, I can put some turbos on the car. I could do a little set of twins or maybe do a few other things and figure some of that out. But I've been looking at it and I'm gonna come out, and I bought this 3-inch donut a while back. So I have some different pieces I can look at and come up with and figure out. So I got a bunch of, I got like a 45 and then a U, and then this is that donut, 2.5, 3-inch. And then I got this here, some V-bands, some stainless V-bands, and then this will step from the 3, which is kind of what's on here. So I could either come right out, go to 2.5, or I think I'm gonna go 3 and then to 2.5 and then put the V-band right there. So we'll see how that goes. I went ahead and picked up a big hole saw, so hopefully I can make a nice round cut here. Probably have to cut this piece out, clean this up, and then make a hole cut here, which will then bring it down, come through here, and then shoot the exhaust as 2.5 inch back behind the suspension there. Then I can bring it out along the side of the car. So I ended up getting the steering rack kind of welded up on the mounts, just tacked in. As you guys can see, it doesn't really fit too perfect. So I will probably have to make some sort of either different mount or something that comes off of here, but otherwise it's on there. I have some shortened links. That's why the wheel is kicked in on both sides, but it worked out to at least see what I need so I can kind of measure and get some longer links in here. But otherwise, the way that it sits, the car will go lock to lock, like inside it'll hit this little stop. So looking like it's not gonna bind up too bad. I was kind of worried about that. Also, it looks like it's gonna clear the pan just enough because I will get and reach up there to the other steering link. On here, I will have to notch the K-member just a little bit, but I ended up getting really lucky with this and it ended up working out hopefully a lot better than what I thought it was. I thought I was gonna have to cut the K-member and change all that up, but that is what I'm working on. So as I was finishing the headers up, I ended up running out of gas on the welder, which is a pain, and it's the weekend, so I will have to wait till the week to get some more of that. So I think that's pretty much where I'm at on it. Gonna mock up, and I can use tape or whatever on some of the exhaust to keep going on it. And then I wanna get the tank put up in the car and start putting together the fuel system. I've already gotten the fuel pump mounted, and it's just a little Walbro 255, which is what should work for the Gen 5 LT, just on motor, not making any sort of crazy power. I'm trying to reuse the stock tank. Kind of looked up everything. These two are vents. This is the sending unit. Looks like this here's a return, so I need to see if I can find an AN adapter for the return. And then on the back side here, here's the feed. So once I'm gonna end up running some rubber hose from that. I'm gonna get the car lifted up so I can show you guys what I'm doing with the fuel system. Having a lift has been so nice, just being able to lift the car up, work on the underside, and then lower it and work on the engine bay or whatever else. Also installing a tranny and all that, it just makes it so much better. Here is the underside of the car. Back here is where the tank would normally sit. And then this is where I've went ahead and put the 255 Walbro inline pump. It worked out pretty well. So that little feed port on the back of the tank will come out right here, and I'm actually going to go ahead and put a stock style pre-filter in it, like just like a little plastic paper filter type deal. And then I'm going to actually need to move this up a little bit. I'll slide the pump up, and then it will be a rubber line into there, come out of there to the rubber line, and then I got an adapter to adapt AN fittings from here, and then I'm going to go ahead and run AN up along the inside of the car, kind of like it was originally, and then go from there. But I think this is gonna work out pretty well. And then I can also take the wiring, go up into the car, and then put the relay for the wiring up in the car. So this is actually worked out pretty well. I made this little bracket right here that comes off the main frame. The stock tank will sit right here, and this is actually the mount for the stock fuel pump and then the mount for the stock fuel filter. So just ended up being real nice. I think it's gonna end up working out really well. I think I'm gonna go ahead and get the tank up in here, or at least build the little line, move this up, build the little line here, and get ready to install it on the tank there. Also, I got some new lines for here to come over to the vent and all of that, and then I need to rewire in the fuel sending unit. As when I pulled the tank down, I didn't realize that wire was there and ended up kind of ripping it. So seems pretty decent. The original fuel return come up right here and then it kind of plugs right into the tank. So if I can get an AN adapter, I can kind of do the same thing. Come over here and meet up with the two lines and head up to the front with that. If you guys can see, also looking at the drive shaft, it looks like it might clear. I might get super lucky and be able to bring the drive shaft just right through here. It'll be a real tight tunnel. But it'd be so nice to not have to modify the tunnel inside the car. And then again, gonna probably go look at the rear end today and get an idea on what brackets I need to order and modify to make my mounts so then I can tie onto the stock mounting for all the factory stuff here.
So one of the most surprising things I'd seen so far is that they had the fuel filter in stock for a 72 Mazda RX2. I can't find any parts, but I can get the fuel filter. All right, so here's the part that makes life easy. This will adapt from the Walbro 255 on this side over to 6AN, and then I got a bunch of 6AN that will be going in, so this will help just make the transition easy from the pump to a inline to run up to the front. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna install one end of a inline onto this number six. I went with number six, I think it's gonna be enough for NA, anything I want to do. If I decide to go nitrous, I might even run a standalone, but 6AN on pump gas, race gas type fuel will support quite a bit of horsepower still. So what I usually do is put a little bit of anti-seize here and then make sure you got a clean cut on this end of your hose, and then you can work this into your fitting, and then the fitting will screw on here, and it will eventually use this taper to squeeze the line and make it a tight fit here. Using a welding glove to make sure I don't mar up the new fitting, since I don't have the fancy little aluminum jaws that they usually have that go into vices. So I got the hose pushed all the way up in here. How much nicer this is instead of poking your fingers 1,000 times with like steel braid. So this is the first car I've used this nylon, and I can already tell it's highly worth the money to not have to stick your fingers 1,000 times. So now I will mount this side into the vise and go ahead and screw the fitting in instead of having to turn the hose every time. And there you go. After it's all screwed in, you get a complete piece here. This side will thread onto the fuel pump, and I will run the long line all the way up to the front of the car, figure out what I need, and then cut it there. And then I'll end up pulling the line back off the car and cleaning it all out before final assembly. I ended up getting the straight on there and actually ended up able to use most of the stock hangers to kind of place it along the frame rail right here. Comes up, goes above my trans mount, and then goes right up into the engine bay, and then I can figure out up above where I'm going to mount the regulator.
So one step forward, two steps back. So I got the regulator, I got the fittings that I've ordered so far, and now I just got to figure out kind of where I'm going to fit this thing and where it's going to be best. I got the fuel hose ran up here, and then also on a Gen 5 LT, you have to come to this port here, and then it goes to the mechanical pump, so it's a little bit different from an LS. I ended up ordering this fitting here, which usually would adapt this to AN, but I got one size too small, so it's not quite there. But usually this little back piece unscrews, it slides over here, and then this will go on top, which would convert it over. I was also talking to Doug at Motion. He told me that if you take this piece off, you can put this right here, so then it's a little bit cleaner, and depending on how you want to run your fuel and stuff, I might leave it like this with this intake, and then if I end up getting a different intake, doing like a 180 or something and running the fuel hose back that route. But I probably should get my brakes all figured out and kind of figure out everything that I need to do and figure out where it's going to be best to place this. I even thought it'd be pretty clean is if I mounted it clear down on the frame rail. It would make it a little bit of a pain to adjust, but once it's adjusted, it'd be nice and clean and out of the way. Then you only have one fuel line that's coming up here. It's pretty much all that it's got to do is come in to this side and then return out the bottom. But then out of this side here is where you would take and it'd come over and deadhead. So instead of having to have a bunch of lines, you just feed it with the feed line here, return there, and then feed the engine here, and then this is going to be set to like 70 psi, and then in the computer, that's kind of one of the things that's a little goofy about Gen 5s is usually this is a variable pressure, and I'm going to be doing it to a set pressure, but hopefully it'll all work out once the time comes to run it and make some power and everything, it'll all work out with this setup. So now I'm making a parts list, trying to get an idea. I need to get whatever the better than 90, like 130 degree or whatever, and I think I'm going to go ahead and run it like that. It looks like there's enough room under the intake to come out the backside of it right here. So then if I end up mounting the regulator right down there on the frame rail, then I can just have one little line that comes up here and it'll come into the regulator and go right back to the tank, which will be really nice. And then I'm trying to figure out what kind of adapter, if they make one, that goes from this little pipe return right there to an 8-in fitting. So that's how it goes. A lot of the times you order what you think you need, you try it, and then you order more stuff to make it work. And that's what I'm gonna do. Gonna get an order together so I can get parts coming this next week. Also get the remote mount water pump and all that coming, so then I can start mounting that and getting that set up. And then it's starting to come together, little pieces like that. And then I think that's when you start feeling that you're towards the end of a project, or midway through a project or whatever, is when you start getting into the little pieces so you can start finishing stuff. So pretty excited about that. I'll get those parts coming and figure out if they even make some of the parts that I'm talking about.
Starting to come along, not too bad. It's kind of working out. Put the part of the donut there and then cut the hole so this could come through, and then it'll have a V-band right here, which will then have this right about there once I get the V-band on, and then that's going to work out pretty decent. Probably going to end up putting a muffler right here, and then it'll end up coming out of the side of the car. So just keep plugging along. I need to get this side cut now, get a hole cut over here, and start tracing that side out.